Good morning, Max. I really like this stuff. Get it from Napper. Works pretty good. Well, good morning, everyone. I thought I would take a second to show you. You gonna help us, Max? Show everybody. Everything that I do to lube up the sawmill. Just like that. Now we get into our wheels. These carriage wheels have axles that are tapered. So that as they wear, they self-center. Some of them are quite worn. But they're producing decent quality lumber. So we're not too worried at the moment. We have a plan to take them. Either do the machining ourselves or take them down to our buddy Ron and have him tune them up for us. We figured we'd just bore out the housings and turn the axle down so that I just go around and hit all these pivots. You can see the set works right here. If you've never seen a lane, she works like that. And then when you turn the lever, it switches the pawls over into reverse mode, or recede, I believe it's called. That's just about everything there. Here's the scale. If you've ever wondered, the scale is a wire. Comes through a little pulley here. And comes up to another little pulley here. And then that is just this weight block. Sits right there. And I got a little turnbuckle there where I can adjust it. Go down here, lubricate this guy. Plenty. Plenty. All right. Put a little on the taper set. If you hadn't seen that before, this handle, you squeeze that, and that whole big guy comes out. So that's where I can do my taper adjustments. Let's see, can I get to these front wheels? Yep. Can't get to that one under there, but that's okay. All right. Since most things, I didn't do the feed chain. I'll hit my guides with some of this. Walking around in circles. So the feed chain right there. Then this axle has the old grease caps. So I just give them half a turn or so. Half, three quarters of a turn. So I think that's the carriage. That's the feed. I wait to oil the mains till later. What I will do is take you in here. Let's check the blower. There's oil in there. Very good. That's a Babbitt box right there. So the last things to do would be the main bearing on the output. We've got a spindle here on the hydro. I'll tup that. Oil in the driven end comes on when we do it. And the main box, there's a grease fitting here and here. And then this is the oil box where the oil goes. And that is actually the shaft right there. All right. I'll get these last couple things done, and then we'll see if we can fire up the deep. Take the extra grease out. Don't worry about a little sawdust in there. That just keeps the oil feed steady. This one's actually intentionally packed with sawdust. We just did two laps around the mill with a red squirrel. Neither of us can hit the side of the mill.
Little bastard's after our donut.
He is. He got into him yesterday, right while we were just standing around.
I've been up here three or four times, you know, during the week, different days, and he's in here bitching.
Yep. Here, I'm gonna hide the donut. Because we'll be sawing and we'll be munching. And away, here we go!
What are you making of that?
One behind, or do you want to slap? Thank you.
be nice to have that loading, that landing in here. Because our driveway, I think it's lower over here, Rob, than over here. It's, I think our driveway is higher near your truck where these logs are stacked. So when we make the brow out here, you can almost have two different loading levels.
Yeah. What I like is I'll be able to bring them right in on the log trailer.
Set them there, yeah.
Fill the deck right up. Well, that one turns out clean.
Make sure your machine's lit. Check your leg.
Oh, does this one pick up my leg? That's up at my knee. I'll have to try it when I'm naked later. At home. Want to bring another one over? Still
coasting.
Still coasting. Away. Oh, isn't that just beautiful? Yeah. So, I'm tired of having a sawdust bath.
So we're gonna adjust the lead a little bit
while Rob and Dave are loading up some oak. That top board, Dave, that dog board that we just made, is gonna be a sideboard for the dump truck. Them on the tire.
It's not a very big ramp. I threw this one over here too, with another side board.
Truck. Let's get you.
Yeah,
so here's what you got for the main box. You got a lock nut and a stud. Lock nut and a stud. And so if you remember this winter, I had to adjust that a little bit. And now I'm gonna take that back out because the frost has gone out. So probably gonna move just two flats on the main bolts there. Nice stuff, ain't it? See, that's where the sawdust goes. All right, I'll put the deck board back down. And we'll saw this maple we got. See if I still get a shower. So, Rob, tell us a little bit about what you got going on and where some of that oak's going.
So, I'm lucky enough to work at the Waldo County Technical Center. And what we have is a program where we actually let freshmen come in, and it's for employability skills, but we do it through woodworking. So we're gonna take a big old chunk of that, and essentially we're gonna make antique looking hammers. Essentially they'll have a nice big curve in them. something that you might have used for driving posts or even back when they used to use like wooden knobs, but kind of an homage to old woodworking ways, even though a lot of the stuff we do now is with the newer tools, because I had a lot of kids get super excited about it, and it's just something to kind of pay homage to the past while moving forward into the future, because essentially these young minds are going to become our next woodworkers. So I just thought it'd be a nice little thing, and luckily Dave and Rob here have the hookup when it comes to how to get this stuff, and just more than, you know, I'm blessed to have this opportunity and to get to share it with my students. So that's the plan, is make hammers.
Very cool. We're really happy to help the kids out.
Absolutely. And so we appreciate it.
Great. Here we go with a maple. up some of this hateful hemlock. More hateful hemlock. Thank you.
over there.
I'm gonna try a angle from back here. You're probably not gonna like it, but you'll get to see the carriage, and you can see the saw, and you can see the carriage workings go round and round thing down there.
Oh yeah, big roundy round.
All right, dogs, head to the truck.
Head to the truck.
Go be safe. Here we go. Let's saw some wood.
Corn guy.
Thank you.
something.